In this video, I'm going to show you how to make the cactus with the red flower. If you want to make the other cactus, please check out my YouTube channel. It's already a video on my YouTube channel. But now we're going to make the cactus with the red flower. If you like making keychains, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel, because I have a lot of other videos available and I'll be adding many more in the future. Please like this video and let me know in the comments if you'd like to see more keychain videos. You can of course use other yarn to make the amigurumi on the videos if you like. The bigger the yarn, the bigger the amigurumi. But now we're going to make this cute little cactus, and we need some yarn, of course. I'm going to use some sport weight cotton yarn and a 2.5 millimeter crochet hook. Of course, if you want, you can use other yarn. This, by the way, a very easy pattern, very suitable for beginners. This is my 2.5 millimeter crochet hook and scissors. You will also need some pins, and I'm going to use this embroidery needle with a blunt point to sew everything together. And of course you need a little bit of stuffing. You don't need much. And then we're going to start. We're going to start with the green part of the cactus, so it's a longer cactus part. Now, I'm going to start with making a chain. First I have to make a slip knot. I do that by making a little loop. Then I'm going to pull the yarn on the back side of the loop, pull it to that little loop, and then pull it. Now I've made a slip knot. The slip knot is not part of the chain. This is just the starting point. And now we're going to make the chain with chain stitches. We're going to make 12 chain stitches. This is the first chain stitch, then the second, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11 and 12. Now we've made 12 chain stitches. Now we're going to crochet in the second stitch from the crochet hook. So skip that first stitch, the 12th stitch, and go into the 11th stitch. Then grab the yarn, pull it through, and then you have two loops in your crochet hook. Now you grab the yarn again and pull it through the two loops in your crochet hook. This is the first single crochet. And now we're going to make another single crochet in the next stitch. And then another single crochet in the next stitch. We're going to continue this until the end of the round, of the row. And then we will have made 11 single crochets. One single crochet in every chain stitch. If you think that I'm going a little bit too fast for you, you can always slow down the video using your YouTube settings. So I have to do two more. And then I'm done with the first row, and I'm going to show you how to do the second row. So first I'm going to make another chain, one chain stitch. And then I'm going to turn my crochet work, and I'm going to a single crochet in the back loops of the last row that we made. So the back loops of all the single crochets. I'm going to make 10 rows in total. So all rows from now on all made exactly the same. So row 2 to 10 are made the same way. I will show you a few rounds. And then I'm going to skip to the end because, well, all these rounds are the same. So I think if you can do one row, you can do 10 rows or even more. If you like to make your cactus bigger, then you can add more chain stitches to your starting chain and add more rows. The more you add, the bigger your cactus will become. Now I've made the second row, I'm going to make a chain stitch and then turn my crochet work. And I'm going to again do the same. Crochet into the back loops of all the single crochets that we made in the second row. I will show you one more round. And then I'm going to skip until I made 10 rows. I really enjoy making little cactuses because, well, everybody likes them. Everybody likes to receive them as a gift. So I already made lots of cactuses. Now I've made 10 rows in total. You can easily check this because some rows are sticking out. There should be 5 rows sticking out. And the beginning of the yarn should be on the left bottom side. And I've ended on the right top side. And now I'm going to crochet round row 1 and 10 together. By going into the back loop of the 10th row. And then I'm going to go into that chain that we made. And I'm going to use a slip stitch to crochet them together. So go into both loops, grab the yarn and pull them immediately to all the loops in your crochet hook. And this way you're going to crochet the two, the first and the 10th round together. I'm almost done. Just have to do 2 more. These last stitches can be a bit harder to find. But once you have done that, then we can cut the yarn and pull it through. And then we have to sew the top of the cactus together. So take your needle, preferably one with a blunt point, and then I'm going to sew this top part together, just one more time to make sure it's nicely closed. And then I'm going to sew between every row that's sticking out, so in the middle. So I have to do this about 5 times. You can see that some rows are a little bump. I'm sewing on the top between those rows. See, now I'm at the beginning again. Now we can pull the yarn to close the top of the cactus. Then it will look like this. I'm going to put in some stuffing in the cactus. Now that I've put some stuffing in the cactus, I'm going to sew in the yarn a few more times on the top of the cactus to make sure that the hole stays closed. Now we're going to use this yarn also to sew the cactus on the pot that we're making. And to do this, I'm going to go dip the yarn into the cactus and go to the bottom of the cactus. And I'm going to attach the yarn by making a little knot on the bottom of the cactus. And then we can use it to sew it on the pot. Well, the look, now it's ready to be sewed on the pot. Before I do that, I'm going to put in so a little bit more stuffing. Oh, and I also need to hide the yarn that's still sticking out of the top of the cactus. Now that I'm done with the cactus, I'm going to make the crochet the pot. I'm going to get some brown yarn, light brown yarn. And first I'm going to make a magic circle. To do this, I'm going to wrap the yarn twice around my finger. Like this. I'm going to hold the yarn in place with my middle finger. And then I'm going to go with my crochet hook in the 2 loops and grab the yarn and pull it through the loop. And then a 1 loop on my crochet hook, and I'm going to grab the yarn again and pull it through the loop on my crochet hook. Now this is a magic circle. If you find it a bit difficult, please check out my detailed video with 2 ways to make a magic circle. It's in the corner of this video right now. Now we're going to single crochet 8 times in this magic circle. Go into the magic circle, grab the yarn, pull it through the magic circle. Now you have 2 loops on your crochet hook, grab the yarn and pull it through both loops. This is the first single crochet. Now I'm going to make the second single crochet. Then another single crochet, the third. Now the fourth single crochet. The fifth, six, seven, and eight, the last one. And now we can close the magic circle. First I'm going to count if I make them all. See to see I made 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we're going to pull that small piece of yarn to close one loop, but not completely yet. So I make the loop smaller. One loop becomes smaller. Now I'm going to pull on the bottom side of that loop to close the other circle completely. And now I can pull on the small piece of yarn again to completely close the magic circle. And then we can start on round two. In round two, we're going to increase 8 times. That means that we're going to single crochet 2 times in every stitch of the round. First, I'm going to place a piece of marker yarn. That's just some leftover yarn that I'm going to use. And then I'm going to single crochet in every stitch of the round. So in this first stitch, I'm going to make my first single crochet. And in the same stitch, I'm also going to make a second single crochet. This is also called an increase. 2 single crochets in the same stitch. I'm going to do this for in every stitch of the round. So make 2 single crochets in every stitch. Then in the end we will have made 16 single crochets. Now I'm going to make my last single crochet for this round, and then I'm going to move the marker yarn, and I'm going to single crochet again, but now only in the back loops of the stitches. So one time in every back loop of every stitch. So you can see that I have 2 loops. I'm going to crochet into the back loop one time. Also in the next stitch, only in the back loop, 1 single crochet. So in the end we will have made 16 single crochets. Now I'm going to move the marker yarn and then start on round 4. In round 4, it's really easy. 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. So, on the both loops of every single crochet, of every stitch. We're going to make 1 single crochet. So, in the end of the round, we will have made 16 single crochets. Now we're going to start with round 5. In round 5, we're going to single crochet 1 time in the first 3 stitches. So the first stitch. In the second stitch, 1 single crochet. In the third stitch, also 1 single crochet. But now we're going to make an increase in the fourth stitch. 2 single crochets in the same stitch. We are going to repeat this 3 more times. So in the first stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second, 1 single crochet. In the third, 1 single crochet. And in the fourth, 2 single crochets. In the same stitch. Now repeat this 2 more times. In the first stitch. Oops. 1 single crochet. In the second, 1 single crochet. In the third, 1 single crochet. And in the fourth stitch, increase. 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Now in the first stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second, 1 single crochet. In the third, 1 single crochet. And then increase 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Now before I continue, first move the marker yarn and then we can start on round 6. Now in round 6, we're going to single crochet in every stitch of the round 1 time. So 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. In the end we have made 20 single crochets. Now this is the last single crochet of round 6. We're going to start with round 7. In round 7 we're going to single crochet 1 time in every front loop of every stitch. So now not the back loop but only the front loop. 1 single crochet. And you do this for every stitch in this round. So in the end we will have made 20 single crochets. Now this is the last single crochet. The last round, round 7, will be the border of our pot. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to fasten off before I make the inside of the pot. So cut the yarn, pull it through. And then I'm going to sew in the remaining yarn into the second stitch of the round. I'll show you exactly how to do that. So in this stitch, I'm going to sew in the remaining yarn. And then I'm going to sew into the last stitch that you made. And this is a nice way to finish the seventh round of the pot. Now I'm going to sew in the remaining yarn and then I'm going to start with making the inside of the pot. Now we're going to attach the brown yarn by, and we're going to attach it to the back loops of round 6. So this is the first back loop. I'm going to get some brown yarn, make a little loop and pull it through the back loop. Now I'm going to get the yarn again and then pull it to that loop to create another loop to make a little chain. And now I'm going to single crochet in the first back loop. So the back loop where we attached the yarn, I'm also going to make the first single crochet. Now in the next back loop, I'm also going to make one single crochet. I'm going to do this for every stitch of this round. In every back loop, one single crochet. Now we're going to start with the next round. In the next round, we're going to decrease 10 times. I usually like to use the invisible decrease, but now I'm going to use the normal decrease because the pot is just too tiny to make invisible decreases. To do this, I'm going to go into the first stitch with my crochet hook, grab the yarn, pull it to the stitch, then I'm going to go into the next stitch also, grab the yarn and pull it through. I have two loops on my crochet hook, I'm going to pull the yarn to all three loops. Now this is a decrease. I'm going to crochet the next two stitches also together, also decrease. I'm going to do this for all the stitches in this round. So crochet every two stitches together. So the next one also a decrease. So we will be making 10 decreases in this round. Now this round is done, round 9, and now I'm going to put some stuffing in the pot before I make the next round. I'm just gonna cut off the yarn that comes out of the That's our starting yarn. And then I'm going to put in some stuffing. In the next round, round 10, we're going to decrease 5 times. So crochet every 2 stitches together. So first these first 2 stitches. Then the next 2 stitches. Then we will have made 5 decreases when we are at the end of this round. Now I'm done with round 10. I'm going to cut the yarn and pull it through. I can also remove the marker yarn now because we do not need it anymore. Oh, I think it's a little bit stuck somewhere. So let's make a little cut in the middle. No, it's not really necessary. I can just pull it out with my embroidery needle. Now I'm going to close the hole that's on top of the pot. There's some stuffing sticking out. You can use your needle to get it inside the pot again. Gonna put in some little bit more stuffing. Of course I cannot get into the pot with my hands, so I'm going to use a chopstick to put the stuffing in the pot. Now I'm going to sew in the remaining yarn in all the front loops of the last round that we made. Then you can pull the yarn to close the hole and sew in the remaining yarn in the soil of the pot. Now we can sew the cactus on the pot. I'm going to sew it over the last 2 rounds that we made from the pot. So rounds 9 and 10. I will show you exactly how to sew the cactus on the pot. Now that we have sealed the cactus on the pot, you only have to hide the remaining yarn inside the cactus. Now, there's a little bit of visible stuffing, so I'm going to use my needle to put the stuffing more in the cactus, so it won't be so visible, like this. And now we can go and make the cactus arm. I'm going to start making a chain with 8 chain stitches. So first we're going to make a loop. Then I'm going to make my first chain stitch, then second chain stitch, now the third chain stitch, the fourth, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now we're going to start to crochet in the second stitch from the hook. I'm going to make 1 single crochet in every stitch, of in every chain stitch, until the end of the round. So in total, we will have made 7 stitches. And this is the first row of our cactus arm. Now I'm going to do one chain stitch and then turn my crochet hook. And I'm going to start with round 2. It's exactly the same as the other cactus part. Just crochet 1 single crochet in every back loop. So only in the back loop of the stitches, 1 single crochet. And we're going to do this for round 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So I will show you how to do 3 rounds. And then I'm going to skip to the part that I made 6 rounds in total. Now I made 6 rows. You can see that 3 rows are sticking out. And I'm going to crochet the first and the 6th row together. So in the 6th row, only go into the back loop and then go into the chain that we made. And use a slip stitch to crochet those rounds together. Now this last stitch is a bit more difficult to see. And when we have crochet all the whole wounds together, the two wounds, we're going to sew the top together, just like we did with the big cactus part. It's the same for the cactus arm. The same way we're going to sew the top together. So now sew on the top part between the rows that are sticking out a bit, that are bumps. So you do that about 3 times. Yeah, I'm going to sew one row further. Makes it a bit easier to close this very small cactus arm. And there's a very small hole, so I'm going to use a little tool to put the stuffing into the cactus arm. I'm using a chopstick. Of course, you can also use something else, like maybe the back of your crochet hook or the back of a paintbrush. Now, to give the cactus arm a bit of a round shape, I'm going to sew on one side, like this, a few times, until I get to the bottom of the cactus side. Now, pull the yarn. And you will see that the arm will become smaller on one side, and it gives it a bit of a round shape. Now I'm going to sew in the yarn to make sure that it stays in that shape. Make a little knot. And then we can sew the cactus arm on our cactus. Now it's time to sew the cactus arm on the cactus. I'm going to use a large pin to put it on the correct spot. And then I will show you exactly how to sew on the cactus arm on the cactus. Now I just have to hide the remaining yarn inside the cactus. Now we are done with the cactus, I'm going to crochet a little flower for my cactus. I'm going to start using a magic circle from Conor Webb, the yarn, 2 times around my finger. Then I'm going to go into the 2 rounds. I'm going to grab the yarn and I have 1 loop on my crochet hook. I'm going to grab the yarn again and pull it to the loop on my crochet hook. Now this is the magic ring or magic circle, and I'm going to make first a slip stitch into the magic circle. I'm going to go into the magic circle, grab the yarn and immediately pull it to the loop on my crochet hook. And then I'm going to make a double crochet. I'm going to go under the yarn. Then I'm going to go into the magic circle. And then I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it to the magic circle. Now I have 3 loops on my crochet hook. First I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it to the first 2 loops. And then I have 2 loops on my crochet hook again. And I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it to both loops. Now I'm going to repeat this. First I'm going to do 1 slip stitch, and then I'm going to do a double crochet again. So go under the yarn, go into the magic circle, grab the yarn, have 3 loops in your crochet hook, grab the yarn and pull it to the first 2 loops, and then grab the yarn again and pull it to the 2 loops in your crochet hook. And then I'm going to make another slip stitch. And another double crochet. Another slip stitch. And then another double crochet. And then a slip stitch. And another double crochet. Now we're going to close the magic circle by pulling a small piece of yarn, and then 1 ring will become smaller. Don't close it completely yet, but pull on that little loop that's becoming smaller on the bottom side to close the other loop completely. And then you can pull the small piece of yarn again to close the magic circle completely. And now we're going to make 1 more slip stitch into the magic circle. And then my flower is done. I just have to cut the yarn, pull it through. And this is how our little flower looks like. I'm going to use my needle to hide the yarn on the back side of the flower. I'm going to make a little knot. I'll first sew it in the back side of the flower. Now I'm going to sew on the flower on the cactus by using a piece of green yarn. This way we're going to make the middle of the flower. I'm going to use a French knot to do this. I'm also going to use this piece of yarn to make a little loop on the side of my cactus so I can turn it into a keychain. So I'm going to go into the flower, and now I'm going to make a French knot. The French knot will be the middle of our flower. The French knot might take a bit of practice to do well, so don't give up if it doesn't work the first time you do it. Maybe practice on another part of the amigurumi first. So wrap the yarn around your finger a few times, around your needle, and then go into the cactus with your needle, like this, and pull the needle, and then it will be, a French knot will be created. And my cat decided to join us. I think he also likes my crochet works. So, like this, and now we can use the remaining yarn to make a little loop on the back side of the cactus, so we can make a keychain from the cactus. So I'm going to use this piece of yarn to make the little loop, and I'm going to hide the remaining yarn under the flower. And there are two pieces of, oh, that doesn't really help. okay, he's gone. Then I can show you that you have to make a little knot with the two green pieces of yarn that's sticking out. I'm gonna hide it under the flower. Make sure you use a square knot to do this, so it doesn't come, you cannot pull it out. And then hide the remaining yarn in the cactus. And now our cactus is done. Thank you very much for watching my video. If you enjoyed making this cactus, please like this video and please also subscribe to my channel. If you like making crocheting amigurumi or little keychains, then please check out all the videos on my YouTube channel. I already made a lot of videos of keychains and also some bigger amigurumi. And you can make them from sport weight cotton yarn, like I did, or you can make them from bigger yarn. So this one is the sport weight cotton, and this one is a chenille, super bulky yarn. I also have many patterns on my website, www.mariskevossen.nl. The link is in the profile of this video. For example, I sell this cute koala pen. I also have a lot of free pens on my website. Please check it out. Because I have many, many pens available. Well, hopefully I'll see you next time. Thank you for watching.